thing is happening with Editas, and that could have a little bit of impact on both Bluebird Bio as well as CRISPR Therapeutics. Let's check that out. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. As we know, we have Reni-cel, which is the equivalent of Cas-CHV and Lyfgenia when it comes to Editas medicine. It's for treatment of sickle cell disease, and you're aware that it's under clinical trials with FDA. That is a new bit of information that has come out in the earnings call of Editas, and I found out about that just now. Let me share that piece of information with you, and then we'll see how it's going to impact not only Editas, but also Bluebird and CRISPR. Well, friends, here we are in the earnings report for Editas Medicine, and we are looking at Reni-cel, which is their sickle cell disease therapy. And the very first line is a blockbuster. It says, alignments with the US Food and Drug Administration that Ruby is now considered the phase 1/2/3 trial to support a BLA filing. Guys, this is big news, and I think this is going to improve the value of Editas, and at the same time, it's going to have a little bit of impact on CRISPR Therapeutics as well as Bluebird, because now there's a third competitor for sickle cell disease market. And when exactly will that happen? When exactly will that impact happen? I don't know. And we have other information out here. It says the company remains on track to present a substantive clinical data set of sickle cell patients with considerable clinical follow-up in the Ruby trial in mid-2024 and further data by year-end 2024. So anywhere between mid-2024 to end of 2024, I think they could get a approval from FDA. So this is a game changer in my opinion. And it's a game changer not only for Editas, but it's a game changer for the other two companies, Bluebird as well as CRISPR, who have got sickle cell therapy in the market. And I think Editas has a superior offering, and we have to see if they get any black box label warnings. If not, then they will be superior to Bluebird. So it's likely to impact Bluebird more than it would impact CRISPR Therapeutics, in my opinion, because not only is Bluebird more expensive than CRISPR, almost $1 million more expensive than CRISPR, but also it has a black box label warning, and CRISPR doesn't have that warning, and CRISPR is $1 million cheaper. So we'll have to see what the price point is going to be for Editas' Reni-cel therapy. Now let us go to the price chart, because we might probably see some opportunities out there in Editas. Well, here we are in the price chart for Editas Medicine. And as you can see, after the earnings, the price went up. This is what I spoke in my other video earlier this, today. Then the price fell down significantly. It's almost a 25% drop from the peak that it had experienced. I have tried to fit a cup and handle in here. I don't know if it is I think it is an unorthodox method of looking at it, because we have some portion out here. But in the past, this has worked for me. So I'm thinking that this is going to be a price target of close to $14.9 or $15. Anywhere between $14.50 and $15 is the price target for Editas. And I'm going to discuss how this is likely to happen. If we look at this section of the earnings report, it says for the full year 2023, net loss attributable to common stockholders was $153.2 million or $2.02 per share, compared to $3.21 per share for the same period in 2022. So there is a good improvement in the EPS. Next, looking at collaboration and other research and development revenues, which was $78.1 million for 2023 as compared to $19.7 million for 2022. I'll round this off to 20. So if you take 20 out of here, you have 58 left. So 58.4 million came from Vertex for the CRISPR license. Now, it's not every day that Editas is going to get $50 million, but it seems to have a stable base of at least $20 million every year. And it has got a cash runway, which can go all the way up to 2026. According to one of the statements out here, just let me find it. Yeah, here it is. It says that it has enough funds to fund operating expenses and capital expenditures well into 2026. So with the current burn rate, they can do that. And if in between any other company were to monetize their therapy, which used CRISPR-Cas9, then just like Vertex, they may come and pay money here, but I don't know if it's going to be $52 million or less. But as long as one company or the other pays revenue out here, they will make R&D income, collaboration and other research and development revenues, which will be excess of $20 million. So that said, we'll also start to see Renicel income coming into Editas. And if you recollect, when CASGEV got approved, instantly CRISPR Therapeutics share shot up, it consolidated, and then it has stayed up since then. I'm expecting something similar to happen to Editas Medicine going forward. And now, friends, for the biggest disclaimer, as always, first of all, genomics is a cutting-edge field, it's a new field, and there's a whole lot of risk, and we are in a high interest rate environment, which is not conducive for startup companies and companies which are capital intensive and that do not have a steady source of revenue. So please always keep that in mind. Second thing is, I'm sharing my personal opinion, not financial advice. So please do your due diligence, because on one end you have fear of missing out, because of which you may end up investing too early and taking too much risk and then losing money. On the other hand, there is a fear of losing money, which prevents you from investing. So there is no way to decide how you should invest, except for you to do the due diligence, look at your own personal situation and decide whether you're willing to take this kind of a risk or not. Because as per my calculation, I'm just going to take a scale widget here and I'm going to move. It's a 68.44% gain for Editas. How soon can that happen? I don't know. How long it will take, that also I don't have an idea, but I can give a ballpark that as we approach middle of this year, things will start becoming more optimistic for Editas and the price will start firming up. And somewhere towards the close of this year, if a BLA is filed, then we'll have a PDUFA date, and that will give it a further spurt. And I think it's going to behave exactly like CRISPR Therapeutics did when they filed the BLA and when the PDUFA date was announced. So that's how I'm looking at this. Please let me know what you think. Put it all in the comment section and we'll take it from there. Wishing you the very best for your day in the market. I'll catch up with you again. See you later.